Sometimes we forget. We forget that Jesus took on all he took on for us. Jesus had to battle the fence just like we had to battle the fence. It's like we have to battle the fence. Luke 23:34 tells us, then said Jesus, forgive them, for they don't even know what they're doing. Can I tell you, the people that do things against the child of God, Lord, forgive them, because they don't even know what they're doing. They don't know what they're bringing on themselves. Hallelujah. Touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. I know we always apply that just to the minister and the preacher, but let me tell you, if you're preaching the gospel, if you're testifying, you belong to God, and they better not do you no harm. Oh, hallelujah. Listen, do you think that Jesus felt good as they stripped his clothes? Stripped him down. Stripped his clothes, slapped his face. Ripped his back, cut it open, spat in his face, nailed him to the cross. Do you think for a moment he was not experiencing pain of rejection and betrayal? Some of you have been betrayed. Somebody's been betrayed. Abandonment, hunger, denial, the wrath of men, hate, prejudice, and shame. You don't think he felt that? He felt it. And in the middle of it, he still said, Father, forgive them. Oh, hallelujah. Somebody needs to stretch out their arms right now. You got somebody you need to say that about. Come on, stretch them out. I'm not even looking. Say, Father, forgive them. Think about who that is. Father, forgive them. For they know not what they do. Forgiveness is costly. It is agreeing to live with the consequences. If someone slaps you, there's no way that can ever be taken back. You've been slapped. But you can be healed, and you can be set free. The thing is, it's a horrible thing to be slapped and then imprisoned by your own anger, bitterness, hate. Vengeance is mine, says the Lord, I will repay. Forgiveness is releasing your brother and your sister who's offended you. We think of ourselves, why should I release him? Let me show you what it looks like. You got them on the shaft. And here you are in life, and you're just dragging people. This is work, people. This is hard. You got Bob and Billy and Sam and Shirley and Kate and Ed, and you drag them through life. And you know, and you're so connected to the wrong thing. When you should be connected here, you can connect yourself here, and you're stuck. You're stuck in time. It happened in 1972. You're still acting like you're in 1972. Still dressing like you're in 1972. Still talking like you're in 1972. 1972 is gone, but because you're connected to the past through unforgiveness, you can't let go. And now you're... When you set them free, you set yourself free. but they're never off of God's hook until they repent. But here's the problem. Sometimes we say, I forgave them. We let them off the hook, but we watch and see when God is going to exact vengeance. I'm going to tell you, if you're still looking, you're not free. If you're still waiting, you're not free. Let me tell you, you need to leave that to God. God's got it. Turn to your neighbor and say, God's got it. All you need, God's got it. Everything you need, God's got it. I guess the translator's going to have to forgive me because I'm not following notes well. Forgiveness is a requirement. Christ forgave us. He requires us to forgive others. We sing about it tonight. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us as we forgive others. Do you really want God to forgive you like you forgive others? We forgive because we need to give others what they need, like God gave us what we need. Forgiveness keeps our heart from the poison of bitterness. Now let me tell you, forgiveness doesn't mean that you're a punching bag. If you can move out of danger. Some of you are in addictive, codependent relationships where all you get is abused, used, betrayed, lied on. That probably is not your friend. If that's happening all the time, you need to evaluate your friendships. In your relationship. But you still need to forgive. And I'll take the responsibility. But if you can get away from the danger, move toward your neighbor and say, if you can get away, move. But while you're moving, you make sure that you forgive. There's something that has to be taken to the pastor. Something that has to be taken to the bishop. Something that has to be taken to a council. There may be something that has to be taken to the police officer. Once you take it there, you leave it with them, and so that God can exact the proper kind of judgment, because you're not able to do that. You must forgive. Turn to your neighbor and say, it's time to forgive. I know he did you wrong. You saw the video, the cards. He used me. You abused, not loved. But at the end, he came back to you, but I forgive. Satan gained ground in our lives because of unforgiveness. The Bible is clear when it tells us we must forgive that we may be forgiven ourselves and God. Tonight, God is calling. I'm asking the worship team to come. God is calling for us to be delivered and set free. The ball is in your court. O Church of God, so that we can cover the earth. So we can cover the earth, not with hate and revenge. Go ahead, Mrs. Jarvis. But with love. Love covers a multitude of people waiting to come back. But you haven't forgiven them. Love will bring them back. And love will heal them. Some of us are angry even maybe with the church. They didn't treat daddy right. They didn't treat mama right. They... Some angry with the pastor. Pastor, maybe angry with members. Been trying to get your breakthrough. Can't get a breakthrough. Forgive. I'm asking you to bow your heads, everybody. We're going to take ground back tonight. Father, I'm asking the prayer team to come. I'm asking many GPs and their wives to come. I'm feeling some of this gas. We're going to pray. Bow your heads, keep your hands bowed. Father, I thank you for your word. I gave, Lord, what you gave me to give. Father, I believe what you said you're going to do, you're going to do. Father, I thank you, oh God, for the word went out and I felt like it was hitting fertile ground. Now, Father, we ask that you would touch every heart. Hearts that have been broken and bruised and used, oh God, and stepped on. But I hear your word saying, come unto me, all ye who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I hear you saying, oh Lord, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, for it has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor and to heal the brokenhearted. Father, when we leave this place, we're going to leave changed. So Father, I bless you now, because your word doesn't return void. Go ahead, raise your hands. If you have